We'll now look at the select by location method that we can use in ArcMap. Just before we continue, I've kept these features that we selected in the previous tutorial video selected. To unselect them, we have the clear selected features tool here or button that you can click and they will disappear. This is important because if something is selected, it might influence the way you do your selections or the selection tools work. Okay, so just a tip from me, always check that everything is unselected before you start a new selection process. Okay, so that's just good practice. Make sure the selection is cleared. If it's not clickable like that, you know that it is clear. Okay, so we're now going to go to select by location. So for that, I'm going to go here, select by location. Okay, so select by location, if we read the description here, select features from one or more target layers based on their location in relation to the features in the source layer. Okay, so it tells us it selects from the target layer based on the location in relation to the source features. Alright, so the target layer then is the layer from which you want to make the selection. So let's say we want to know which mines are within a kilometer of rivers. Okay, so that's a simple question to ask. We've got mines, we have rivers. Okay, so what I want to do, my target layer will be mines. Okay, because that's what it says there. That's where from what I want to make my selection. I'm asking a question about mines. Okay, so select features from active mines. So that's my selection method. Okay, again, there's different selection methods here. Again, there's an add to current selected features, remove from, select from current selected. The same as with select by attributes. Just make sure it's just worded a bit differently because it's select by location, but make sure you use the correct method for what you want to do. So I'm going to say select features from active mines. We will get to that. Okay, so, and I want to know which mines are within, let's say, a kilometer of rivers. Okay, so that's my source layer in relation to the features in the source layer. Okay, so I want to measure from rivers and see which of these mines are within a kilometer from them. Now, there's a second function here that's not in select by attributes, and that is the spatial selection method. Okay, that needs to be applied. And there's a number of them. Let me just try and move this up a bit so you can see it more clearly. Okay, so we have intersect the source layer feature. So that would be where two features, where the active mines and the hydrology rivers intersect. So that would mean the mine should be on top of the river. Okay, so that's going to be highly unlikely, right? Because mines aren't generally located in rivers, okay, except if it's a sand mine. Are within a distance of source layer. Okay, so that sounds like what we would like to use, but there are many others contain the source layer feature, are within the source layer feature, are completely within the source layer feature. So this would be, let's say, select all towns within the northwest province. So if we have a layer showing the northwest province and we want to say select all towns that are inside the northwest province, this would be the selection method that would be applicable. Let's say we're using rivers. Okay, so we want to select all rivers that's within the Northwest province. What will happen here is all the rivers will be selected even if they cross the boundary. So even if that line crosses the boundary, if I used are completely within the source layer feature, it will only select rivers that don't cross the boundary, that are within the province fully, you know, in totality within the province. Touch the boundary of the source layer feature, share a line segment of the source layer feature. Okay, so there's different selection methods we can use. For this one, we want to use distance. And then it's going to ask us, what's the distance? Okay, and this is important here, that you specify the unit that you're working in. So we're going to use kilometers. I'm going to say 1 kilometer. I'm going to say apply. And let's just move this. There we can see all the mines that are within 1 kilometer of rivers have been selected based on the location of the mines relative to the rivers in the secondary data set. So select by attributes, your selection is based only on one layer, on one data set. Select by location, it is always based on more than one layer. Okay, because you need the location of your layer from which you are selecting relative to another layer. Okay, so that's very important to take note of when using select by location. So let's clear this selection. Let's now just say this is just for the purposes of illustration. Let's select all the mines that are within the vegetation layers, which basically represents South Africa, which will be all of them, but I just want to show you are within the source layer feature. Okay, so now we're going to select all mines that are within the source layer feature, which is vegetation. We're not going to apply search distance, okay? So we just want to know which ones are within. I'm going to say apply, and all of them are selected. Okay, so the different techniques will depend on which layers you are using, what questions you are asking, but they're fairly descriptive, so you'll be able to identify the ones that you want to use. The ones that you will be using most are within a distance of and intersect the source layer feature. Okay, so we'll look at a few examples in the next video where I'm going to discuss hybrid selection methods. But for now, you just need to know the basic understanding of select by location. Okay, so you select from your target layer. Okay, and you can see you can select from more than one at the same time. Okay, so let's say you had mines here, you had towns here, you had whatever else might have been here, you could apply the same rule to all of them and select from all of these layers simultaneously in relation to, let's say, the rivers data set. Okay, so that is possible to do based on a spatial selection criteria that you apply here. Okay, so again, pause this video or go to your ArcMap rather and just play around with the select by location tool. Using this example data, see what you come up with. In the next video, we will be looking at hybrid selections.